Good morning, you guys. This is such an exciting day. I'm just checking up here. I got to pick up my groceries today. It's been a week, and this order just keeps growing, so we just keep adding to it and adding to it, and it's grocery day. Yesterday, I cleaned my fridge. It just is beautiful and shiny, and I'm going to start loading everything in. So it's a big day today. But while I have the phone up, I want to show you guys something. Hi, Lori. Hi, Kathy. Hi, Aaron Barry. Okay, you guys, look it. Come in real close here. This, I keep talking about. See where it says popular group topics? Do you see that? If you hit see all, it expands to all of these options, and then you can select those. Hey, I want to do a partner workout. You click on partner workout, and it'll pull up all the videos that are partner workouts, right? Got that? So I want you to use those tabs and go find some workouts. I have all the live classes are on there, and thanks to Dina Wampold, I changed the formatting so it says live, then the name of the workout, and then the date that we actually did that workout. So if you use that live, swole, April 3rd. So if you want to go back and do them, they're all categorized. But take advantage. This is where you guys are getting what I think is great value with all these extra little tidbits. Some of them are techniques, some are mini workouts, core. So get on there and mess around and play with that, and then let me know what you think. Kind of proud of myself for that one, I gotta say. Okay, good morning. It is Monday. We are here again. Still in quarantine. We're still keeping our Gretchen. Remember what a Gretchen is? 6 feet tall, 6 feet of distance. Keep your Gretchens. Hope you guys are sticking with us, still working out. You know, it's kind of a chance for you to decide, do you want to just survive this whole thing, or do you want to thrive in this whole thing? And I think so many of us are going to come out stronger and better than ever. I think the most amazing message is, you guys are warming up right now, right? You know how this works. You got to start warming up. My daughter's over here mimicking me. I'm about to get over there. So stop it. So are you going to survive, or are you going to thrive during this time? And I really challenge you to thrive and come out of this thing stronger. These workouts, yes, I say all the time, we set the bar up here. These workouts are for everybody. We have so many ages and strength levels of people doing these classes. I give you options and alternatives, and I keep telling you, I am here for you. If you have questions, message me, say, how can I tweak this? I've got this issue. I'll give you options. Even if you have never worked out in this style before, you can do these workouts. It is for everybody. That is my goal, to keep everybody moving. So that being said, let's get rolling. I have one challenge for you. You're still warming up, right? Okay, at some point during this workout, I don't care when you decide to do it, it's on you. I want you to just let out a scream, a yell, because you know what we are? We keep saying we're gonna be okay, we're gonna get through this, and we are. That doesn't mean that it really just kind of doesn't suck sometimes and you feel overwhelmed by it. I know I've had those feelings, and I'm sure a lot of you have too, and it's okay to not be okay all the time. So why don't you at some point during this workout just let out a little, let out something, and everyone in the house will just think that you're working hard, but I will know and you will know that it's your way of getting it out, right? Okay, so do that for me. Are you warmed up? Are you moving? All right, we got Grace in the house. My daughter Grace is back, feeling great. Migraine is long gone. She's fit as a fiddle and feeling awesome. Today's workout, if you heard the music that was playing in the beginning, it was a little MC Hammer. That's because today the workout is called Break It Down, and we're gonna break it down for you like this. If you like short bursts of work, you are going to love today's workout because that's the goal. Here we go. Good morning. Okay, so we go like this. You're gonna start with one big move. Then we're gonna take that big move and we're gonna break it down into smaller parts, and then we'll circle back to the big move. Does that make sense? You'll do the big move, I'll show you how it works, for 30 seconds, then there'll be mostly two, one time there'll be three little single moves of that broken down, and then we'll go back to the big move for 30 seconds. So it's a 30, 20, 20, 30. After every two sets of work, we're gonna throw in the big 40 seconds of a cardio of your choosing. I will give a suggestion. If you have something that you love, like Palo Alto's for days, just do that every time. That will only happen five times. So be thinking about what cardio move you want to do. Are you ready to get rock and rolling? Let's do this. I'm gonna grab my timer. It's good to see you guys. There's a lot of you out there today. Hi, Kathleen, Cindy. Alrighty, Tara. Saw the spot on King 5 with the tulips, loved it. Hi, Sabrina. Okay, listen. 30 seconds of a burpee. Grace, let's show them a burpee. You're gonna jump up, jump back, into a push-up. Don't forget the push-up, and then jump up. Make sure you're jumping up with your feet flat. If you don't jump back, what do? Exactly, you step back. Step, step, step. Please add the push-up in the burpee. It's a proper burpee. Step back, drop to your knees if you need to for that push-up. Then we're gonna break it down. We're gonna go to just push-ups, and then a set of just the squat thrust, which is the burpee minus the push-up. Got it? So So let's do this. Cue up your music, people. 30 seconds of the burpee. Again, remember, you can just step it if you don't want to jump back for your back. On your mark. Are we ready? Team, 30 seconds. Burpees. Go. Hit it. Here we go. Down and back. Push up. There we go. Feel free to drop to your knees if you need to. Jump back and hit that push up. Kick those hands a little bit wide. Yes. Keep it going. Only 30 seconds, people, and you're already halfway there, Molly. You got this. You got this, Allie. Come on, Erica. Let's go. 20 seconds. 20 seconds. Let me know if you're out there, people. Come on. You got 8 seconds. Can you do two more? Grace can. Yes, you can. In 3, 2, rest. Stay down on that floor. We're going to go right into push-ups for 20 seconds. Are you ready? Go. Drop to your knees if you need to. Be on all fours. Crawl over to a wall and do them against the wall. There is a way to make this happen. If you have a definite issue where you cannot do push-ups, then you're on your back and you're doing some chest flies. Got it? Chest flies. That's the big hug move, because we love a big hug. You got this, Grace. 2 seconds. And rest. Now you're back up or back into squat thrust. That's the jump back, jump up, no push-up. Or you're stepping back. You have your options. Let's do this. And go. If you don't want to do anything getting down to the floor, just squat it out, people. Just squat it out. There's nothing with just squatting it out. Come on. Come on. 20 seconds. This is short. You love these little short timings? I think you do. Mary, do you like the short ones?
Uh-huh.
You got 3 seconds. And 2. And rest. And now we are back to that big set. The 30 seconds of burpees. Are you ready for this?
Yeah.
You guys are going to love this one. It's going to fly by. Let's go. 30 seconds of burpees. Catch your breath. Go. Look out. Let's go. Here she goes. Jumping back. Don't get that push up. Step, step. When you come up, make sure you're coming up. Hi, Michelle. Flat footed, right? Flat footed to protect those knees. Maybe come up with your feet a little bit wider, especially if you're stepping it back. Chest is up. Butt is down. You got 12 seconds. 12 seconds. How many more can you do? Did you get that push up in there? Did you do your push up? You got 3 seconds, people. And 2. And rest, and just like that, set one is done. Drink some water, wipe some sweat. That's how this is gonna go, 11 rounds, just like that. Next round, squat press. Find some dumbbells you wanna push overhead. You're going to squat and press. Sitting down and back in that squat, and an overhead press. Stomach tight. After that, you're going to just either drop the weight or hold some weights, and you're just gonna squat. After that, you're just gonna stand there, and you're just going to press. Got it? Squat, press, back to squat, press. On your mark. What's the time? That's right, 30 seconds. Let's do this. On your mark. Get set. Squat, press. Go. Hi, Julie. Come on, you got this. Come on, I know I miss having you here. This is your home office, away from home. We miss you. Gosh, I miss you guys. It's so crazy. But you're going to thrive, not just survive. We got this. We do. Even when it is awful, we got this. And it feels so good to feel strong, doesn't it? Doesn't it feel good? Yes, answer me. Okay, thank you. Good, 8 seconds, come on, Grace. Down and back in those heels, people, putting all your weight into your heels. Stay out of your toes, stick your little cute booties out. And rest, and just like that, we go into squats. If you're gonna hold weight, put it here at your shoulders or keep them real close to your body. Let's go, just squat, 20 seconds, hit it. 20 seconds of squats, down and back. Pushing those hips back, keeping that chest up, remember? Chest up. Chest up. This is going to be a fast workout, I'm feeling today. So I want you, because it's a short time, to push yourself a little bit in these windows to your level. Whatever that looks like for you. Got it? You got this. And rest. And here we go into the shoulder press. Nothing but shoulder press. Are you ready for this? Let's do it. Go. These are so short. You're going to set your amount, right? Wherever you are. Wherever you are. Maybe you're like, I don't know, I'm going to do one, I'm going to sit here and think for a second, and then do another one. It's up to you, people. Just do something. Anything. Anything. Just keep moving. We all need to keep moving. I'm going to have to do this workout later because I haven't done it yet. And rest. Then we go back to the big one. Oh, you love my workouts? Thank you. That means the world. Let's go. Back to it. 30 seconds. I really do love going into my think tank and coming up with these formats for you, trying to keep it fresh and different. And some you might like and some you might not like, but I'm doing my best to keep it fun and different. And just, you know, that first grade teacher in me comes out and I try to get creative. Come on, are you still squatting? Are you still squatting? Down and back. Grace, how are you doing?
Great.
Okay, keep it up, people. 7 seconds. 7 seconds. 5 seconds. Yes, you can, because it's almost over. And just like that, Good. Alrighty, we are into our first cardio. 40 seconds of cardio. What are you going to do? No, commit. I want to hear it. Okay, I'm good with that.
Okay.
I'm good with that. Grace, do you want to do what?
I'm going to do gate swings.
Gate swings. Alrighty, Grace is on gate swings. Oh, Sabrina, Deirdre, Allie, and Erica. Mwah. Alrighty, gate swings. That's going to drop low into a plie. Cross and drop. Cross and drop. Are you ready? 40 seconds. Hi, Pamela LaRusso. Here we go. 40 seconds. Gretchen smiling because you're there. And go. 40 seconds. Hit it.
Hit it.
Dropping it low. Drop low. Remember, you just have to keep moving. Are you going to go super duper fast right now, or are you just going to do one? Just do something. I guarantee you, when it hurts getting you breathing harder, good for the lungs. Make sure you still got that lung capacity. You go at the level that works for you. Maybe you're like, I feel so good today, man. I feel so good. And you're going to go super fast. You do what you need to do. Just keep moving for 40 seconds. Right? 40 seconds. Maybe you're just going to modify. Do a little tap and a little drop. You've only got 8 more seconds. You can finish this. 5 seconds. 5 seconds. And 3. And 2. And rest. Well done. That wasn't bad, was it? Wasn't bad. No? Okay. Great. Let's move on. Set 3 of work. You will need bicep weight. Look around. What are you grabbing? Spaghetti sauce? Wine bottles? Dumbbells? What do you got? What you got? What you got? Alrighty then. Biceps. You're going to start it off with a bicep curtsy lunge. So you're doing a curtsy like the queen. Oh my gosh, did you see her little talk? That was so lovely. Crossing it over, right? Not a backstepping lunge, but a cross. Crossing over into that curtsy as you do a bicep curl. Keep those elbows back. Drop that back knee low and that front foot. Dig that heel hard into the floor. Hi, Dina. Just keep it going. Keep it going. So bicep curtsy, then we're going to break it down. And you're gonna put the weights down and we're gonna hit those Apollo Onos. That's this one. Libby, you're welcome, right? Maybe you're gonna touch the floor in each one. Maybe you're just gonna keep it right here. You do what works for you. After that, you're just gonna hit some biceps. Easy peasy, break it down. Let's go, and then back to the bicep curtsy lunge. Did you find your bicep weight? Are you ready? Let's do this. Survivors ready? Go, hi Nola, hi Nancy, let's go. Here it comes, 30 seconds. Now dropping that back knee. Nice and deep, and putting your weight into that front lead heel is that's going to protect your knees. So step deep and drop that back knee. That is what's going to make this little fella very sore tomorrow. So let's do this. 10 more seconds. Just 10 more seconds. Nice form, Grace. Look at how Grace is keeping her elbows back. Elbows back. Good work, Grace. 2 seconds. And rest. Put down those weights. Let's get those Apollo Onos going. Those step them up. So you ready for it? Yes, you are. Let's do this. This is flying by. Go, 20 seconds. Hit it. Hi, Eileen. Nice to see you. Mwah. Dawn, you're there too. Mwah. Let's go, Grace. Drop that back knee. Push, 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 push. Mike Wompold is doing this one today, or is he just hanging out? Mr. Mike Wompold in the house. Come on, Mike. Go. Push it. Push it. Push it. 3, 2, and rest. Wow, nice. Bicep curls. Bicep curls. Let's do it. Let's do it. Let's do it. Elbows right here and curling. Remember, you're keeping those elbows beneath your shoulders. If you pull them forward, you're using the front of your shoulder. You're not isolating the bicep. So to keep that isolated, you want it right here. Don't do this. Don't do that. That's not going to help you at all. You want total isolation by keeping them right here. Hey, Eileen, I know you still got that boot on your foot, but you could sure be doing these bicep curls now, couldn't you? Yes, you could. How's that? And rest. Back to the combo. Put it all together again. We roll. Bicep curtsy lunge. Let's do it. 30 seconds, people. Come on. Come on. How you doing out there? Chime in if you have not chimed in. I want to know you're here during this next inter-session. I want to know. Before we move on to the next exercise, I want to know who else is out there. There's 50 of you, but I want to know who else is out there hiding. Come on. 10 seconds. 10 more seconds, keep going, do not stop. I'll tell you when to stop, I'll tell you when you're gonna stop. You're gonna stop when this little thing says 3-0. We're nowhere near that right now. We're at 2-9, and that's the 3-0 mark. Nicely done, biceps. Alrighty, this next round will involve a lateral side raise. So you wanna choose lighter weights. Like I would do that move with 5s. So something small for a lateral raise. Then you're also gonna be doing some lunging. Mm-hmm. And so you might want a heavier set of weights during just the lunge. If you want to weight that lunge, you can hold something here or have something in each hand that's heavier. You're going to start with alternating forward stepping lunges. with a lateral raise. So forward and down and forward and down. I want you to think about doing this. When you take that big step, high scissoring, that you step long enough, drop that back knee, front knee stays right over that ankle, right? Right over that ankle. Yet you're gonna do a little lateral, alternating with each one. Then we're gonna break that one down, and you're gonna be just holding a lunge right here, up and down, up and down, up and down. You're gonna do that for 20 seconds. Woo! And then you're gonna hit the other one for 20 seconds, and then we're gonna side raise it for 20 seconds, and then we'll put them all back together. Hi, Angie, are you ready? That was a big break, there's a lot to explain. I'm running out of words. Go, 30 seconds, step forward, bend that back knee, take it down to about 3 inches off that floor with a big lateral raise. If you're right now thinking, boy, this weight's too heavy, bend those elbows and take it to right here. Remember, the closer the weight is to your body, the easier the work will be. Hi, Abby. Get them way, hi, Midora, get them way out there if you can. If it feels too heavy, keep the weight closer to your body with a bent elbow. Alternating legs, alternating legs. Dana, you're already breathing that heavy? Good, I like to hear it. Hi, Erica.
Me too.
Good morning, and a rest. All righty, step into a lunge. If you want weight, that's fine. Just step into it, front knee over your ankle, shoulders back, chest up, hips forward, toes forward, and you are up and down. Go. Remember, you are that little carousel pony. That pole is running straight down your body. You're going up and down. Carousel horses do not move this way. That would not be safe. There was a little one in front of Kmart years ago up on Aurora. People, remember that one? It kind of went all over the place. 25 cents. The girls loved that one.
I remember that.
Remember that? We'd go up there just so you can ride that stupid thing. All righty. And switch legs. Switch legs. Let's go. And 20 seconds over here. Go. Drop that back knee. Drop that back knee. That's where all the love comes. Pushing your front heel hard into the floor. Push that front heel in. Engage those glutes. Use those glutes. Come on. Come on, Grace. How you doing?
Good.
She's a little bit sweaty. That's a good thing. But she's got this. She's got this. Three more seconds, you guys. Yes, you do. Yes, you do. And rest. Alrighty. Now just chill out right here. Press the shoulder. Side raise. If you want to make it big, straighten those arms a little more. Otherwise, bend those elbows. And go. Nope. Just the side raise. There you go. Got to break it down. This is the last broken down part. We go back to the whole thing.
It's a three.
It was a three. That's right. That was one of the three moves. A lot of ways to break these down. Trying to keep it simple. I thought this would be a workout that everybody would have success because it's short and the moves are simple. So we're going to be just fine. Give me three more seconds. And two. And let's put it all together again. Everybody come back together. Oh, I can't wait for the day that we all come back together. All right. Let's go. 30 seconds. Go. 30 seconds. Elbows can be bent. Roll this. Keep these shoulders down and away from your ears. You don't want to be up here like this, right? Keep it here. Posture is key. Pulling those shoulders back and chest out, and you're here and you're here. For seven more seconds, yes you are. Or maybe you're out here. I don't know, you do you. What are you doing? What's it look like for you? Maybe it just hurts so much right now you have no weight in your hands and you're just doing this with your hands. Totally legit. Rest, you did it. Alrighty, back to cardio. What are you gonna do? Now, you didn't get a lot, hi Ashley, you did not get a lot of, hi Maddie, Palo Otos. So if you want to do those right now for your cardio, I totally would support that choice. Make your decision. Maybe you're gonna do fast feet. Maybe you're gonna do Palo Otos. Grace, what are you gonna do?
Palo Otos.
Grace is going to Palo Otos. It's her favorite as well. She loves you, Libby. Go, 40 seconds, 40 seconds. Maybe you're gonna do fast feet with me. Come on, let's do it. Hey, did anybody have sore calf muscles from the other day, that farmer's walk? On the tiptoe and then the plie tiptoes, remember that? Yeah, good, 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 good. Was hoping. Come on. Come on. Yes, keep it coming. Woo, it's getting warm there. It's getting warm in here. Hi, Becky. I'm going to send Grace over there and turn the heat down a little while. But she's got more to go. People, you got 11 seconds. Let's push it a little bit harder. A little bit harder. Your harder, whatever your harder is. Come on. Let's do this. 7 seconds. 6, 5. Four, how are we doing? 3, 2, and rest. Oh my gosh. Push that down there a little bit. All righty, guys. Drink some water. Drink some water. Like this. Here's the straw. Here's my favorite cup. Hey, did you like our new little logo? Big shout out to Travis Anderson for doing that. He just whips that stuff up. I love it. It has strength. It's kind of gritty, kind of edgy. The swirl for the O. Hello. So good. Love Travis. Okay, we're gonna go after those triceps. Are you ready for it? I know you are. All right, we're gonna kick it off with a move called the dancing crab. We're gonna hit the floor. This one, you're also gonna need your chair and a mat. You have to transition pretty quickly in between them. So starting with Nancy Crab, you're down on the floor like you're gonna do a crab walk. Remember in grade school, you do this in the gym. So you're down doing a crab walk, ideally. And you're gonna hold up. Fingers should be pointed towards your toes, so turn those hands around, there we go. And you're gonna reach right hand to left foot, up, and then the other side. Now you can just reach and touch, or you can make it plyometric with a bit of a hop. It's up to you. Got it? Then you're gonna go into your chair and do dips. Popping off the edge of that seat. Make sure it's somewhere stable so it doesn't slide. Tricep dips. After that, you're gonna go right to that mat, lie on your back, legs straight up in the air, and alternating reach to those toes for that core. Got it? Are we ready? I know the dancing crab is a challenge, but you can do it. 30 seconds. Does not have to be plyometric, people. You do you, you do you. Let's go! Dancing crab. Dance those crabbies away, people. We gotta get those crabby patties out of here. Let's go. Reach. You don't have to do a plyo. Maybe you do one time high, Lisa. Maybe one time it's plyo. And then one time you're just gonna reach it up. Shoulder alternatives, Lisa, I know. That surgery has probably been put off for a while, right? Yep. Tell me which moves are bugging you. If you can find a different range of motion, go super duper light, right? Go ahead and go to the floor and do chest stuff if you need to. That's also gonna use your shoulders. Just be very careful. Because now we gotta wait for that surgery, I'm guessing. Yes. And rest. All right, let's go to the dips. Go to your chair, go to your coffee table, something stable. Shoulders back, chest out, 20 seconds, go. Most important thing, make sure your booty right here is as close to the edge as possible. You wanna go straight down, wrist can turn sideways so you can see that. Straight down, shoulders back, chest out, and just know how that upper arm is parallel to the ground. Don't go deeper than that. You gotta be really careful on shoulders. Like, Lisa, this is not a good one for you with your shoulders, right? Very easy to tear the rotator cuff if you're not being careful on this one. And rest. Hi, Sarah. Good morning. Let's go on the mat. This is kind of a good easy round, don't you think? 20 seconds. Let's do this. Reach. Go. Reach. And reach. And reach. And reach. Can you guys see Grace all right? This is kind of a work in progress for us here. We are learning how to do this. I never thought I'd be in front of a camera like this. And so we're kind of figuring it out and just kind of keeping it real, keeping it kind of old school. So far, so good, I think. You got 2 seconds, people. And rest, and we are back to the dancing crab. I kind of put on that, yeah, I need two more though. Dancing crab. Are you gonna make it plyo this time? Don't have to, let's do this. Reach, and reach, and reach. Lisa, is it on this dancing crab? I'm not sure what to do. Just get on the floor, get on your back and do some core work or make it a skull crusher. I'm trying to get those triceps, make it a skull crusher. Make it a kick back. We know you can do that one. You're almost there though, 3 more seconds. And two. And rest. Oh my gosh, I shortchanged you 5 seconds. That is your gift. That is the gift that keeps on giving. Oh, I don't. Oh, Susan, how dare you? Yes, you're welcome. Let's go. You will need heavier weights for a wide back row. So remember, the closer the weight is to your body, I'll just keep saying this till it sinks in, the heavier you can use, right? You're gonna be here. So a decent amount of heavy, not as heavy as you would if you're doing a back fly. Right? So you're gonna do a wide back row. I want you to drop really low, really low. So take those feet apart, it makes it easier. Sit down and back nice and wide. I can't believe I just shortchanged you guys 5 seconds. You all owe me triceps later. Anywho, really wide, really low, elbows up and back. Put those eyes on the floor about 5 feet ahead of you to protect the neck, holding your core super tight. Dig those feet into the floor in a wide back row. Then we're gonna break that down and you're just gonna do a wide squat with or without the weights. You can do what I like to call a suitcase squat, hold the weights here. Then you're just gonna do your nice wide back row and we'll go back into it. Let's do this, wide back row. Are you ready? 30 seconds, 30, 3-0, Susan. Susan, here we go, hit it, go. In a nice little squat, raise your toes forward, toes forward. Yep, there we go, there we go. Get it low, I want you to feel a little burn in the quads right there, people, a little burn in the quads. 47 people watching. Hey, we usually have about 60. Where are your friends? Get on them. Get on them. I know a lot of you are planning to do this one later. Not you, because you're here now. But come on, people. We like these views. Let's go. You got 7 seconds. Drop a little lower. I know. Oh, you popped up. Get down. Lower. Lower. I know you. I know what you're doing. Rest. Let's just squat. You want to hold them down here or hold the weight right here or at your shoulders, whatever works best for you. Let's do this. Hit it. 20 seconds, I'm gonna be on it. I'm never gonna rip you guys off again. I feel horrible. Can't believe it. 5 whole seconds. 2, 5. Come on. How you feeling, Grace?
I'm tired.
she's tired already. I know, she's got her online classes today, so she's gonna have to just suck it up and get through this. And time, rest, take it into a nice, hi Michelle, wide back row. So you don't wanna get as low this time, stomach tight, and 20 seconds, go. Chin down, people, eyes on the floor, 5 feet ahead, core is tight. If you're feeling the need to jump up like this at all, drop your weight. I want a big squeeze between those shoulder blades. Right here, elbows go up and back. Targeting this. Eyes on the floor, 5 feet ahead of you. Protect that neck. There we go. You got this. Alrighty, let's go. Put them back together. Drop it low. Challenge yourself this time. How low can you hold that squat? Which means you really gotta hold that core tight, right? Okay, Lisa, maybe you're gonna be better in a close row. Think about that. And go. Drop it low. Yes, we can. Get low. How low can you go, people? Drop it down. Core tight. Chin's down. Stay with it. I'm just gonna dance it out for you. You're halfway. Keep going, people. That's right. Come on. What are you listening to? I always wonder. Anybody do something very bizarre for their music? Okay, just like to know. 5 seconds. 4, 3, and 2, and rest. Nicely done, people. Just like that, we're back to the cardio. What are you gonna do? Grace is going to do toe taps to a ball. Will your hands be up to spike the heart rate more? Okay,
yes,
good. Excellent. Grace is going to do toe taps on the ball. Maybe you're going to do back jacks. What are you going to do? Are you ready for it? Whatever it is, it's going to last 40 seconds. On your mark. Get set. Go. 40 seconds. Here we go. Push it. Let's just get it really high. Push it. A little bit harder. Yeah, it's going to feel so good when you're done, you guys. I know right now it's like, oh, I don't know. I haven't even heard from my sister yet. She's usually on there right away, so she better still be doing this, Kathy. Come on. Keep it going, people. You're just going to have a dance party for 40 seconds. Put on your favorite song and dance it out. That's an option. Keep it moving. Keep going. Hi, Julie. Oh, that's true. Dance. Let's do this one. You will need one heavy item. If you have a kettle, that's ideal. Lori, I know you have one. You are going to do a plie, feet wide, yes, Nancy, you're welcome. Feet wide, toes out, holding your weight here. You're going to drop down low, pull the weight high. Drop down low, pull the weight high, right? Now, it can be a major power move with a lot of speed. It can also be I'm just gonna do it. Whatever works for you. Then you're gonna break that one down. Break it down, and you'll do a plie squat. If you want to have weight, you can just hold that weight right here, down and up, and then we'll take that out and just do a high pull. Let's go. Plie with a high pull, 30 seconds.
We're doing all right. Oh, yawn. I told you I'm tired.
All right, let's do this, people. Plie high pull, 30 seconds, starting now. Let's go. Come on, what speed do you want to do this move? This is so great for these delts right here. Side of your shoulders, that high pull maneuver. So the weight should be coming right to the chest line. Elbows are high. The weight is lower than your elbows. You got this. You're halfway right now. Drop it deep in that plie, pushing through your heels. That's what's targeting your inner thigh. We love that. Was it the thigh gap or something? It was all the thing. That's crazy talk. And down and up. Core tight. Straight down. Not sticking your booty back as much as you would in a regular squat. And there it is. Rest. Now just the plie squat. Holding the weight, or put the weight down, and up. Let's go, 20 seconds, go. Pushing those heels, hard into the floor, straight down, chest up. The song that's on is cracking me up right now. I think Chris actually requested it. Can you hear it? Then we'll probably get our video pulled down. We'll get in trouble, DJ. Come on, people, 3 seconds, 2. That's not a motivated song. And rest. High pull, right here. You can bring your feet in a little bit, give a little bit of a break, and just high pull. Let's go. Remember, you're pushing the shoulders down as your elbows come up and the weight's coming to right there. Got it? Good. Keep going. You're doing this, people. You're doing this. There are 4 rounds of work after this. You're gonna crush this thing. We'll be done by probably quarter till, I'm guessing. Something like that. It's not so bad. And then you're gonna go pull one of those tabs and do one of the little corsets that are on there and rest. Let's put it all together. Plie, high pull, corset. I said it again. On your mark, get set. Plie, high pull, go. Let's do this. Down and up. Down And we got this. It's a beautiful day here in Seattle. It's going to be a gorgeous sunny day. It's going to be a sunny week. Get outside. Stay away, though. People are still just like clustering. I hear Green Lake is crazy time with people. So keep your distance. Go somewhere where you don't think you're going to see a single person, but breathe that fresh air. Go to your backyard. Backyard and try one of my little family fun videos. There's a lot of good stuff in there, people. You got 2 seconds. And rest. Woo! Alrighty, nice. Okay, this one's a bit of a challenge. You're gonna need mid-range weights. You're gonna get down on the floor and you're gonna kick it off with a renegade drill, one of my very favorite moves. So you're gonna high plank, right? Open your feet a little bit wide, that's gonna stabilize you. And you're going to alternating row, elbows tight to your side, hold that weight. Of course, you can drop to your knees. Grace, wanna show that? Perfect. Yep. And it's still gonna be really good. In fact, Grace, why don't you just do it on your knees so they see. It's okay, it, you guys, it's totally no shame in the game if you go to your knees. There is total worth in that too. So you're gonna do the renegade row for 30 seconds, then you're gonna stand up with those weights and just do a close row like this. Elbows tight to your side, pulling it in, popping off over here about me. And then you're just gonna get down to the floor and hold a high plank. No weight, just hold a high plank. Got it, and then back to the renegade row. That's exactly right. Let's do this. 30 seconds of the renegade row. Weight in each hand. Hi, well, Miss Wanda, when you're down here alternating, right, like this, if it's really uncomfortable for you to do it that way, you could do one side and then hit the other side. Let's go. 30 seconds. Hit it. 30 seconds. Let's go. If it's too much for you, drop your weight, people. Yes. Yes, totally, just drop your weight. Just using your arms with no weight is totally valid. You do not have to do this with a lot of weight. The goal is to be successful and get through this. Hi, Casey, and to get through the workout. And if that means without weights for any of it, then do that. You're still moving. Look at Grace, she's on her knees, totally fine. Happy, she's just hanging out there, pulling big, elbows, and rest. Up she gets, close row. Bend those knees, stomach tight. Those weights are right by your side. Where are your eyes? That's right, 5 feet on the floor ahead of you. Go, close row, bend those knees, get really set. You can open your feet a little bit wider or have them close together. This is for that back. Again, we're looking for that big squeeze right between here, right? Right through the shoulder blades, big squeeze. You've got 8 more seconds. 8 more seconds, row it. Row it good, people. And rest. Now you're just gonna drop down into a high plank. So arms are straight and extended. Right, and just hold that plank. Make sure that it actually is a plank, right? You want your body long, and her bottom's not dropping the same, so that's gonna hurt your lower back. It's not up too high, or you're taking the work out of your core. You wanna get all this good stuff right here, right? So just hold tight. Feel like one more challenge, you can raise one arm, then raise the other arm, or just stay right there. What else could you do? Drop your knees, exactly. Drop your knees if you need to. You're almost there. 3, 2, and rest, and we put it all together again. Back to the renegade row. Get on those toes if you want, or stay on your knees and hang out, and just doing this motion, and go. 30 seconds. 30 seconds. Keep it coming, people. 30 seconds. Alternating. There we go. Grace, that's good. How you feeling? You feel a little quaky in those arms yet, people?
Yes.
A little quaky. Hey, are y'all still out there? Is anybody out there still? Hello? Anyone out there? So alone right now. Oh well, I've got my people right here. You got 7 seconds. 6, 5. Come on, 4. You got this. You are thriving, not just surviving, people. And rest. Guess what? Back to cardio. Gosh, it goes fast, isn't it? What's your cardio going to be, Grace?
Back jacks. Compliment that.
Complimenting the back work. That's right. Remember the back jack is a jumping jack.
They're coming out like this with a big squeeze
between those shoulder blades, right? Back jack. On your mark, 40 seconds, we got this. What are you doing? Shout it out, commit, thank you. Nice to know you're there, Maddie. Let's go. Hit, 40 seconds. Back jacks, okay? You wanna do back jacks, but you don't have a lot left in you? You're going like this. Are you still moving? Yes, you are. Does that count? Yes, it does. This counts, people. Just keep moving, I don't care how big it is. Just keep moving. Hi, Becky. Oh good, I'm so glad you're sweating, but that's funny. How can you be sweating right now if you're typing me a message? See, it's kind of a trick. I like to see who stops. Hi, Carrie. You got Gavin on there with you? Yes? Let's go, people. You got 10 seconds of cardio. 10. Make it big. How big can you go? Just this little tiny bit left. You got 5 seconds. Push it hard. Oh, 4, 3. Keep breathing. 2, around, you'll be lying on your back. You're welcome. You're very welcome. I want you to find your heaviest weights for a chest press. Heavy weights for a chest press, whatever heavy means to you. Heavy might be 5 pounds. Heavy might be those 50-pound dumbbells. I don't know where you got those. Hi, Sarah. But go get what is heavy for you. Get on your back on that mat. You're going to do a chest press and a bridge. Now, I want you to be careful. If you're pushing really big, heavy weights, maybe leave the bridge out and just focus on that. Just be careful with this one, right? For your back. So you're chest pressing. That's this one. Did you watch the tutorial? Do that one too. Click chest press and watch that video. It's one of my favorite ones. And as you do that, you're driving up into a bridge through your heels. Now, Grace had asked this morning, does it matter what goes when? It doesn't matter. You can all be up, all be down, or up then down. Do whatever feels natural. Hi, Jessica. Whatever feels natural to you. Got it? Chest press. Your elbows are going to be, you can see this right here, right about there. So not above her shoulders and not too far down. And you are going to flex that chest as you extend. Then we'll break that down. You're right. We'll do a bridge. We'll do chest press and put it all together again. Are you ready? 30 seconds. Go. Chest press with the bridge. Up and down. It is your job to really squeeze those glutes and drive hard through those heels and take it up nice and high. That bridge is working the glutes, the hammies, and the deep core muscles. It's kind of getting it all for you right there in one happy little move. And you're doing great. Yes. And really think about it. Remember, we're working this chest. So really think about engaging those muscles as you push. Use them. Make this do the work for you. You got 5 seconds. You got four. How many more can you do? 3, 2. That'll do. All right, we're gonna hit the bridge. If you wanna take it up a notch, you're gonna put those weights right here on your hips. Hold on to them so they don't roll into your face. 20 seconds of bridging. And go. And go. And go. Now, some people like to leave it up in the top and pulse it for 20 seconds. You can totally do that. Whatever works best for you. Whatever burns the right way. You like the burn. Apparently that burns because Grace just made a very funny look with her face. So that's okay. So keep going. Keep going, Grace. You got 3 seconds, honey. You got this. 3, 2, and rest. All right, take it back into a chest press. Just the press. Are you ready for it? Go. Relax the bod, just the press. Elbows come down, all the way up. A little bit different than when you're using the bar, right? If you're used to using chest press with the bar, your arms are always gonna be up there. But with dumbbells, go ahead and take them centered and then bring them down. And just really think about engaging this and pushing through your chest. That's right. How are you doing? Mid back, is it deep into the mat? Good job. It gives you a little bit of core work and protects your back too. Keep going, people. Keep going. And rest.
Yes.
Let's put them back together. We all come together again. Press and bridge. And 30 seconds. Grace is excited because she knows we're getting so close. Two more sets of work after this, people. She wants breakfast. You got this. You got this. She's going to hold her bridge high this time. That's another option. Does that feel natural for you? Then do it that way. You can do that. Whatever works for you. Hi, Mandy. Make this work for you. That is my goal. I'll keep working for you if you'll keep working for me. Deal? Because we're going to thrive, not just survive. This is our goal. You're almost there, Grace. You got 6 seconds, you guys. Come on, give me a few more. Keep breathing. Shh. Breathe out on that push. Breathe out on that push. Yes, and rest. All right. Next round. You will need very light weights. Very light weights. You will want something very comfy for beneath your knees. You're going to get down on the floor. Let me show you how this one's going to work. You're on your knees. Open your knees up a little bit wide. It is your job to squeeze your glutes and core super tight to stabilize you. Like literally pinch a penny. You know what I'm talking about? You will have those light dumbbells up here. You will reach back, touch the heel, come up. I want your eyes to follow your range of motion. Follow and look. Reach and up and reach and up with those light weights. Then we're gonna break it down. You will want to either keep those weights or grab something heavier. And you're going to sit back on your haunches and then come up to a squeeze. So you're down and you are squeezed. Down and squeeze. After that, we'll take both of those weights and we'll just do this range. Just do this range. Now, obviously, if you have shoulder issues and this is not a range of motion for you, maybe you'll do more of this. Maybe you'll do some of this. Maybe you'll do some of this. And if this is not an option, if being on your knees is not an option for you, then you're going to stand up and do a reach like this. Are we ready? Yes? Yeah. And you can even add in a little squat. Let's go. 30 seconds. Hit it. Yes, I know this is Nancy's favorite move. You're welcome. I see the TY. I know you love this. Arms straight. Arms stay straight. Big reach. Look down and back with that big reach. Arms straight. Grace, don't bend that elbow.
Wait, the whole time.
Big reach. Yeah, the whole time. Arms straight. You guys are probably doing that too. Very natural to want to bend that, right? Keep it straight with a big reach and look down. Can you get to your heel with a big turn? That's gonna get the obliques as you reach back. You've got 4 seconds, and three, and two, and rest. All right, either with or without weight. Keep the weight close to your body, though, if you're choosing to do it with weight. Sit back on your haunches, come up into a squeeze. Actively squeeze, pinch a penny, people. Do it. Very tight, down and up. Again, if it's not an option for you, you are standing and you are just doing a nice little squat right here and really squeezing those glutes with each one. You're almost there. Keep it coming. Keep going. Big squeeze. Sit and squeeze. And sit and squeeze. How are we doing? Everybody still with me? Hi, Soul! Out there in New York, how you doing? Keep it going. Want to have Irish dance music going? Okay, then. All right, then. You know, I'm so good at Irish dance, right? It's a little known fact. And rest. Okay, now you're just up here, right? Two weights. Big. If that's not an option for you, you're going to take it here. You're going to take it here. Then you're going to take it right back here where we've already been today. Nothing wrong with that. 20 seconds. The big reach down. Take it big. Take it big. Let's get all those lats in there, too. Good job, Gracie. Keep it with. Come on, come on. A little more. Don't stop on me now, people. How many friends are you going to share this link with today? Then send them a message and say, come play with us. Come play with us. You can do your own private watch party during these workouts too, you know. And rest, let's put it back together. Hi, Erin. Let's put it back together. Here we go. Big reach, arms straight. Arm straight, down and up, and down and up. And make sure you are really looking in that rotation back, yes? Hey, even if you're too busy working out to chime in that you're here now, maybe chime in later so I can see everybody who is here. Like at the end, but I'm kind of rambling on when we're done. That'd be nice. I'd appreciate that. You're almost there. You got how many seconds left? Five. Oh, high five. We haven't high five for a while. High five. You're killing it, people. You're doing great. Good news, too. You got cardio coming up. And rest. Let's do this. Cardio. Grace, what do you want to do?
Squat jumps.
What's wrong with that child? Squat jumps. All right, what are you going to do, people? Commit. I couldn't hear you. Okay, perfect. Oh, she's going to add in the 180 twist, too. 40 seconds of squat jumps. So Grace is going to do this one, reaching to the outside toe. Ah! Are you ready? 40 seconds. Go. Let's do it. Come on, let's go big, people. Go big. Get your music. Tell the kids to turn the music up and push yourself through. This is your last cardio burst. It's your last cardio burst, and you're going to leave nothing behind because you're going to be down on the floor for the last set. Leave nothing behind right now. You can go a little bit harder, a little bit faster, no matter what that means. Whether you start here, you go to here, or maybe you start here and you're going to here. Just go hard. Come on, thriving here, thriving. We got this, people, come on. Living your best life right now. This is as good as it gets right now, people. Come on, I'm using my outdoor voice just because I'm a rebel like that. I'm gonna use my outdoor voice. There's not a lot of outdoor right now, but I'm gonna use it. Here it comes, you got 1 second and rest. Yes! Woo! Okay, drink your water, people. I'll take it back to my indoor voice. Okay, indoors. Last round, people. It's core round. You're going to be down on the floor. You're going to do a rotating side plank. So I'd like your arms like this and your feet wide. If you don't have your feet wide, they're going to crash into each other. We need some Gretchening, social distancing, right, with those feet, right? Spread them apart. So you're going to be down like this, on your, ideally on your toes, and of course we can go to your knees, and you're going to roll open to one side, literally onto the sides of your shoes, the part of your shoe that never gets any love, the side, that's going to touch the ground. Then you're going to roll it the other way, and then you're going to roll it the other way, back and back and back and back. Then you're going to hold side plank. Hi, Amy. You're going to hold side plank on one side and just hang out there. If you want to take that up a notch, put a small weight in your hand and hold that up like this. So side plank to one side. And you'll hold that for 20, then you'll hold front plank for 20, and then you'll hold the other side for 20. And then we'll come back to the rotating. Are you ready for it? Let's finish this. This is a big set. Of course, you can do it on your knees. If you're on your knees in that rotating plank, you're just gonna reach and look up. And just reach and look up to alternate it. Are you ready? And go. Hit it, let's do this. You do love side planks? That is good to know, because you guys tell me what you like, and I make sure to put it in there. Someone messaged me last night and said, can we please have it? I'm like, it's already in there. So tell me what you want, people. I want this to be different than any other workout formats that are out there right now because you can call the shots. It wasn't programmed in some studios in Hollywood 3 months ago. It's happening right now. And I'll go home tonight and start thinking about Wednesday's workout. So let me know what you're looking for and I will give it to you. That's the special everything about this place.
And rest.
All right, side plank, side plank. Now, of course, get down. I'll get down there with you for a second. Side plank.
You ready, Grace?
You can stack your feet. Can you see my feet? You can stack your feet. You can split them like this. You can drop that bottom knee. The critical thing is that you're leaving those hips high, and if you poke yourself down here, it's all gets a little more firm, doesn't it? Arm can be up here with weight, or just up here. But go ahead and take your option, whatever you need to do to hold that plank. Dropping the knee is not a bad thing, people. It really doesn't change it that much. So go ahead and do it, and I totally support you in that.
How are you, Grace?
Good.
She's hanging in there. Coming up, we're gonna go into that front plank.
Somebody's ready.
Roll it to the front. Now listen, I want you to try for even just a second. Hi, Gloria, to do it on your toes. Go.
And go. And she's holding firm.
Come on, you like these 20-second intervals? Is that working for you? Because we're gonna have some bigger ones coming up this week, so just stay with me. Something different.
Gotta keep it fresh, gotta keep it different, right? How are we doing?
How are you doing out there in that front plank? Are you on your toes? Just for 1 second, pop up there. Get on your toes. Just give it to me, just for a little bit. Just for a little bit. I know you can.
Yes, you can.
Actually, have 3 more seconds. And 2. And rest. Let's hit the other side.
Now that's a precedent. You can roll right into it without dropping to your knees in between. That's pretty cool.
And go. 20 seconds. Other side plank. You know, planking is something, I think there's a video up under core that's all different variations on planking. Maybe give that one a go later today, right? You have so many choices. Take advantage of it.
Nice, Grace.
There you go. Your shoulder's about to give out. Make sure you're keeping that elbow right beneath your shoulder. They should be mildly fatigued by now, I'm just going to say. So make sure you're being smart. And rest. And let's take it to that rotating back and forth. And
somebody's ready. Let's go.
30 seconds. Hit it. Roll it.
And then back the other way. Big reach.
Literally get to the sides of your shoes, people. Make it full. That's what's going to work. Your sides, then your front, and then the side again, right? Keep going. So good to work those sides. Get that cut in like this. I always say this in another class that I teach. When you walk in a room, you walk this way, right? So if you're kind of cut here, people see you. If you entered rooms like this, it'd be a problem, right? This doesn't show. It's all good. You got 4 seconds. There's Marilyn. She's there. You are so sweet. Thank you. Grace, are you okay? Guess what, people? Done. You did it. You survived another one. You did it. Hi, Annie. You survived it. Thank you for your fun posts. I love Annie. I love seeing your workout space. I really want to keep building this community, you guys. So share it with your friends, but explain to them a little bit, because everyone's like, yeah, there's 5 million things out there. There's the Beachbody, and there are a lot of options for workouts online and that are free or that are charged. I'm in a fitness professionals group, and everybody pretty much is doing something like this right now. With a donation gift option, which I so appreciate those of you who are helping out with that. It's my only business, this is my only source of income, and I want to be here for you guys too. Truly, this is bringing me all kinds of crazy joy. So I love you guys, have a good day, make good choices, enjoy the scent, and don't leave me yet, Hallie, I know you're there. Don't leave till you do this. Reach all the way up, Grace, you in? A little bit higher. Jenny Stone, take it down.
And pat yourself on the back.
Well done, y'all. See you Wednesday. Be prepared. Let me